right, welcome back. So, I started off a little different this time, obviously. Let's talk about other investment opportunities, which might actually be just as good as gold. Actually, it might actually be a little bit more important. In the private group, we're talking about, nothing's confirmed, I haven't committed. I don't know about you guys, but I'm heading for the hills either way. Alone or with a group, I'm going. I'm done. Now's the time. Well, the time was probably this past summer, but I was waiting for, I'm not sure. Waiting to see what happens with the elections. So, also, I made a conspiracy tinfoil theorizing video. It's an hour long. I'm gonna post it tonight in the newsroom and possibly another social media platform. I can't put the links. Well, the link for the newsroom is below this video. So there, you just have to click on it and download the app. It's free. It's like not hard. I know it's hard for some of you, but it's really not that hard. or you can find me on BitChute. And I never say the name because now, you know, let's just say this platform doesn't like that. But I can't upload it here. There's no way. I pretty much lay out what I think is going on, what's happening. And it's not even what I think is going on. I know what's going on. I've known since I was a kid about all this stuff. Like, I know people who actually toured with these guys and other guys. The music, rock bands and everything. I know people all over the place. Military, this and that. My family, let's just say they knew some people. So I made a video. I feel morally obligated, and it's sort of urgent. Now, for the private group, I'm going to make another video, and I'm going to tell them what's coming. I'm not going to tell everyone. I can't do that. But that will be in the private group. By the way, the sale is still going on. You just type MMG Invest. Go to my website and you add the private group to your shopping cart. It's $220. Normally it used to be $300, but people are, you know, losing their livelihood. So, and that's just that. There's a huge dip buying opportunity, and I want you guys to take advantage of that in gold and mining stocks. We mainly research mining stocks, but I also trade other things. And I put on a short. I'm short in the market. But you add it to your shopping cart. You go to your shopping cart. My dog's barking. He really hates that Amazon truck. And you click apply discount code, and it's $132. And then pay attention. Then the next day you will get an email with a link to the Patreon group where you sign up and you pay another $10, and then it's $10 every month for all the updates. But that's not the private group. Once you pay and then you message me back your information I need, then I give you the links to all of the private groups. The news group, not the newsroom, the alerts room, the private group where we talk, and then there's like a couple other rooms. now there's, what did I call it? Self-sufficient or reliant land group. Vacation retreat group. that's where we are at right now. And in the private group we're talking about maybe crowdfunding, because it's really cheap that way. to get like acres and acres and acres of land, and it could be a getaway, a vacation getaway. Also, if the economy, you know, implodes, the power goes out, or you name it, or if you want to avoid, you know, the forced jabbings, right? Let's just say times are going to get strange and very, very uncertain, and I'm going to talk about that. And I don't know about you, but I want to be somewhere beautiful, somewhere safe. And, you know, this would be a little extreme, right? A house on a little island. This is just some Instagram account. I look at their stuff. These are the people I follow on my Instagram. But, yeah, listen, an island wouldn't be that great because you have to get resources to the island, and that's extremely expensive, hard, and not practical. But, you know, on the mainland, there's definitely places where the population density is extremely low. And there's all kinds of things. You could go whitewater rafting. You could go mountain climbing, skiing, snowmobiling, hot springs. What else? You could fly a plane around. You could hunt, right? See, that's life. That's life. Lake, fishing, you name it. There's definitely a great sense of life out in nature. Of course, it is hard work because if you want to be self-sustained, you're going to have to do a little bit of farming. But if you have a community and everyone does what they're good at or what they have experience with, and everyone puts their heads together, not only can we get more done and be self-sufficient and reliable, but you could have fun with people, right? You could throw some parties. You have a nice like-minded community, and it could be a good time while the rest of the world sort of falls apart around you in the urban centers, the urbanites. When they escape the cities, and they will. Actually, they already are. And that's another reason why I think this might be, well, an opportunity. Because I was shopping for real estate, right? And the prices out in the middle of nowhere in nature and beautiful landscapes, I mean, they have more than doubled for land and homes. Not all of them, but a lot of them. Some of them have tripled. It's insane. And I don't think things are going to normalize anytime soon. There's multiple reasons, right? One, the entire financial system is an entire bubble. Two, the currency, it's going to crash. Three, the supply chain has been extremely disrupted. That's another word I could use, but it's been broken, and it's going to continue to break because the supply chain these days is global. Like your bananas, your apples, they come from literally halfway around the world. But even in the U.S., the small farms, they have to slaughter a lot of their cattle and chickens and their animals because you have to understand, during the lockdowns and whatnot, the supply chain was broken. And if they can't go a month without harvesting their crops and harvesting even the animals, so they had to slaughter them because they couldn't afford to feed them. And after that, you're in big trouble because now you don't even have your stock, your livestock. And a lot of them have gone bankrupt. And I'm actually looking at some of those properties. where small farms, like mom and pop farms, are going under. So I think the prices for areas where, let's just say, the population density is extremely low, it's extremely quiet, it's pure nature, the prices are only going to go up. Also, I mean, there's with the elections, right? It doesn't matter who wins. You're going to see conflict. Now, it's not going to be like, the one of the greatest movies ever, The Patriot. This is like new age warfare and whatnot, but it would probably resemble more so what happened in the UK in the 70s and 80s. I don't want to be in the suburbs. It's currently where I'm at right now. I don't feel safe. I've been doing all kinds of crazy stuff. extra locks and windows. You could get security film on them, all kinds of things. And I don't think you're going to be safe even on the farms right outside of the suburbs. Listen, there's a lot of people. Population, it's different what it used to be. All right. Now, I talk a lot about this in my conspiracy video that I'm uploading later tonight in the newsroom, links below, which will be good. It'll be good, a good one. It actually gets better the longer you watch it towards the end. It starts off slow and then picks up. But listen, during the good times, and the good times were the last like 2, 3 decades, it's been slowly deteriorating for the middle class and whatnot. But globally, as a whole, through globalization, everyone has life, their lives have gotten better, with including technological advancements and whatnot. But the good times, what it does is the cities suck in all the youth, it sucks in all the people, right? Manufacturing especially has just sort of been extracted US and militarily and economically because of Cove, and they're bragging and they're laughing at us. They're like, they're never gonna unlock them. They're locked up. Will never end. God willing, it destroyed them, and they're just laughing at us. But yeah, I mean, our corporate overlords, I talk about them in the other video. They exported the manufacturing, right, to the rest of the world. So a lot of people were forced to go into the cities in the US. And the cities grew all over the world. Now, I said this in my other video. This is fractal. This is Fibonacci. This is the tale of empires. During the good times, everyone goes into the cities. And then finally, the empire collapses on itself, on its debt, or the smallest thing comes and triggers and pops the bubble, or the empire's overextension, gluttons and degeneracy and all that that we see today. And expending ex its expenditures running wild and corruption running wild. Something comes and always pops that bubble. And it was Cove. So imagine these population centers, these major cities, these urban dense areas as sand castles. Now everyone's built a sand castle on the beach. You need to use water, and you could build a pretty tall castle, sand castle. Well, what happens once the water runs out? It starts falling apart. Well, that's kind of what's happening now. The middle class has ran out. People's savings have ran out. Liquidity has ran out. I know they're injecting liquidity, but the value of the currency is gone because the cattle that back up the currency of the nation no longer have jobs because all of their small businesses went under. So the water has dried up. The liquidity has dried up. The sandcastle is about to implode on itself. So all of these 3D spikes, this is a three-dimensional map. And this came out a few months ago of population density. So imagine all these spikes that go up into the sky, which represent population density, made of sand, and it's just going to all collapse. It's just going to collapse on itself. So what's going to happen when that happens? People are going to flee. And a lot of these people, they work on computers. They shuffle paperwork. They're middlemen. They're, you know, not real jobs. They don't have life skills. If they can't go through a drive-thru or go to the grocery store, they'll just starve. So it's a good idea to not be anywhere near them. And on top of that, we have balkanization. On top of that, we have political civil unrest. On top of that, we're going to have other forms of it, of people attacking each other. I talk about that in my other video. It's rooted very deeply in human psychology, and it's happened throughout the past. And it's no one's talking about that either. So I talk about a lot of things, and I swear, listen, guys, I know of everyone out there on the internet. Nobody's mentioned a few of the things that I mentioned in my other video. Yes, I repeat a lot of the things they talk about, but there's a couple things. So pay attention to biological advancements coming out for the elites. Pay attention to the psychology of long-term COVID. And then towards the end of the video, the other stuff. Okay. And if you're young, you haven't seen this stuff. This stuff's a little bit from the past that is way more, it's definitely been deleted everywhere almost. It's hard to find. Anyways, so I think a lot of people are going to flee to the same areas, right? Or to the areas least populated. So you want to be there first. So the value of your land is probably going to go up. And people are going to be spread out much more after all of this is done. And this could last a very long time. 5 to 10 years. Maybe longer. It's kind of like a modern Dark Ages. Cypherpunk. Whatever you want to think of it as. It's going to be kind of like that. And whoever is self-sufficient will survive. And maybe all you have to do is make it past the next, like, 6 years. And all of the entire thing's gonna shit. It'll all hit the fan. And the people in charge now may not hold on to their power. Yes, they all have places where they can run and hide, but when they come back out, there'll still be people around. Maybe not as many, but they're not going to have that that power, because they've overstepped, and they played their cards too early, and they're not going to be able to control this. There's no way. And not just that. I mean, historically, this has been tried over and over. Nothing's new, guys. It's just we have different technology, and there's just more people. That's all it is, in my opinion. So this is why I am looking at, I think this is important because, you know, you might have money, you might have metals, you might have bitcoins, but what's the most important thing? Your life and being safe. And I was hoping by now metals would have gone higher and the mining stocks. But I didn't really foresee in advance, like a couple years, this pandemic. So it kind of caught me off guard. So now everything is being quickened and the metals haven't caught a bid, but I'm very hopeful for this summer and spring. It's going to do it again. Like the past spring and summer, mining stocks and metals exploded. Well, next spring and summer, they're going to explode even more. So by then we'll have everything ready to go, set, the land picked out, and it'll be cheap if everyone pools their money. And then you could go there for vacations, and if need be, worst comes to worst, it's a place you could go, and you know there's like-minded people there, and we all help each other out, and everyone owns their own plot on the land, right? But you know, you also have a community you could fall back on, and everyone, because with numbers you have strength. When you're alone, trust me, a lot of people are going to leave the cities and they're going to go and raid. It's going to be like, I don't want to say Mad Max, but probably, like, it could get there. And not just that, I mean, we're looking at all kinds of things. As the elites get desperate, as countries get desperate, China could only expand. If it doesn't, it implodes on itself because its population, and it needs the resources because they don't have it on their land. You know, there's emerging empires. Like, the power could get knocked out. If that happens for more than 3 weeks, that is Mad Max. That's all it takes. Probably within, I mean, with the current environment, it would probably only take 4 days, 5 days of no power, and it's Mad Max. After 3 months, like, more than half the population's gone. 6 months, it's like 90%. But in that time period, it's very, very dangerous, right? It's survival of the ruthless, of the savage. And, yeah, so I'm excited. I'm excited about nature. And, you know, there's nothing better for your soul and to calm you down during stressful times than nature. And the quiet. And the animals. You can see the stars. You know. And you could have a great time. You could go quadding, ATVs, dirt bikes, I mean, jet skis. Some of the best times I've ever had in my life was actually just going camping and going on, you know, vacations like that. Skiing, snowboarding. So, I'm excited. Hunting, shooting, right? I'm done talking about that. Let's talk about the markets. Give it a second to load. Yeah, so the private group, it's all about thrive, but also survive. So you have to survive to thrive. And if you just make it through the hard times, there's going to be so many opportunities. The best opportunities in your life is when there's blood in the streets, in the markets, referring to the markets. But basically, that's going to happen too, and that's going to transfer to the markets, unfortunately. So the VIX, I mean, it hit my magic blue equilibrium line. It's probably going to bounce back up soon, within days, weeks, months, just looking at the VIX, which is the volatility index. The dollar has been tanking hard. And you know what that makes me think? That makes me think that for the dollar to rebound and to not drop like an anchor, the market needs to correct. And I think they're going to let the market correct. It's extremely overextended. It's been going up for like 8 months. It's like unheard of. It's like the longest streak probably ever. Or one of them. And if the market corrects, that'll give the dollar a nice dead cat bounce or some sort of rebound, maybe a retest of the 200-week moving average. And then the Fed will come out and do QE, and then the dollar will fall back down. The market will start pumping back up and rebounding, and it might hit new all-time highs. It may not. I don't know. We'll get there when we get there. I can't predict the market exactly, and especially with all the manipulation, but I'm pretty good at it. But we'll see. It all depends on how deep the correction is. So you take this week by week. Now, I'll talk about gold in a second. And look, the 10-year treasury yield, it's getting pretty close to 1%. And I told you guys, it's going to get shaky as it heads to 1%. And the market will definitely correct by the time it even gets to like 1.2% or 1.4 or 5%. At that point, the market's going to be accelerating to the downside. So, yeah, but one of the main reasons I'm thinking this market is really ready to correct is it's extremely overextended, even with the oscillators on the weekly here. The oscillators are on the bottom, MACD, RSI. I have other oscillators, a momentum oscillator. But also, if we look at, if we use one of my awesome indicators that has worked out very well. So check this out. This is the NASDAQ composite. NASDAQ is all the FANG stocks, which if the FANG stocks correct, the whole, they'll take down the entire market with it. Because most of the U.S. economy at this point is literally tech stocks, which is unbelievable. It's not even a real economy. But that's what happens when you consolidate and during a crisis, and they get all the bailouts, right? And then everyone has to shop with them. The 1-hourly looks ready to correct. The 4-hourly time frame looks ready to correct. It's getting hot, the heat map. It's on an 8-count. 9 counts are corrections. Let's take a look at the 12-hourly. 12-hourly, I have a sell signal. It's ready to correct. And today's Monday, by the way. Markets just closed like half hour ago. Here's the daily chart. It's Monday the 7th, December 7th, 2020. The daily chart for NASDAQ, sell signal. It's ready to go. 3-day, 8-count. So by the end of this week, it's on 9-sell. It's close enough. The weekly, it's on a 6-count. Technically, with the weekly, there might be 3 more weeks of upside, maybe 4 at the most. But because there's so many sell signals on the smaller time frames, I'm gonna ignore the weekly. Also, if you look at the oscillators, it's pretty overextended to the upside. Let's just take a look at the monthly real quick. Let's do the monthly. It's on an 8-count. So next month, it's on a 9-sell signal. So I placed some shorts and options for the beginning of 2021. And I bought some shares of inverse ETFs and whatnot. So I'm right at my entire portfolio is hedged, my account, right? Just in case. But there's another reason why I think the market's going to correct soon. One thing, things are getting pretty hot politically, and Trump's chances are improving by the day. And it's starting to look really good in his favor. And honestly, guys, this is how things really work in the real world. So when this goes to, let's say, politicians, judges, but really the Supreme Court, you know how they're going to vote? Based on what? They're not. It's not going to be based on facts, evidence, and the law, I believe, personally. What it will be based off of is what is better for the system, for them to keep their jobs, and for the peasants not to show up with pitchforks and torches. And this is how I look. This is how I look at it. If the orange guy wins, yes, there's going to be civil unrest and riots and whatnot. But those useful idiots and, you know, the basement dwellers and losers, they could get squashed easily. But the orange guy doesn't win, then you have a serious problem on your hands. Because you have the middle class, or what's left of it, and about 80, probably more, probably 100 million or more, real pissed off Americans. Because most of them think they agree with the orange guy, right? So, and not just that, then they all lose confidence in the entire system. At that point, when everyone loses confidence in the system, there are no laws. Everyone starts disobeying, and things are going to escalate real quick. And the leftists, they're not going to stop. So it doesn't matter who wins. They're just going to keep going and doing what they do and destroy. And it's already started today, and attacking people and whatnot. They're going to do it anyways, no matter who wins. But what I feel the system is afraid of is if the right comes out, because they actually have real men and they could do real damage. Matter of fact, if they actually went balls to the wall, I don't think they could be stopped. So that's what it's going to come down to. Okay? And there's evidence and there's other stuff going on that I'm not going to talk about. But I do post that stuff in the newsroom. So all the things I can't talk about, so my channel doesn't get nuked, I put it in my chat groups, the free ones, so you guys could see, so you're on the same page. Unfortunately, people don't go there, or I mean, I'm saying there's almost like 2,000 people who watch me, but there's usually around 300 people in the chat, in the free news chat room, the free one, just looking at the stuff. And whatever goes in there is like, it just came hot off the presses, at least within a few hours. So, yeah. So, and that helps you, I guess, with markets and just knowing what's going on in the world. All right. Let's take a look at gold. So listen, if I'm expecting the market to correct, another reason why the market will correct if the orange guy wins is it might spike that day. It might go up a couple days he wins, like right after he wins, or everyone knows or thinks he's going to. But we're probably not going to find out till next year. So I think things are just going to get very heated because, listen, I mean, it's pretty much like a civil war within the state, and there's a lot of desperate people who are afraid of getting locked up. So things are going to get crazy in the next few weeks. Also, the chances of him winning as it goes up, Wall Street's going to look at that as like not good, because he's not going to do as much stimulus as the other administration. He's still going to do a lot, but not as much as the other guy. So I'm talking about Sleepy, of course, Biden. And the market, it doesn't matter. It's going to correct. It has to. It just can't keep going up like this. And then after the correction, they're going to come out with more stimulus, don't worry. And then probably spring of 2021, the market's going to go right back up and start making new highs again. So what does this mean for gold and silver? Because today, they really spiked gold and silver. And for my last video, I told you guys, you know, you might want to get in now. That's why I put out the discount a week ago. My last video was like a week ago. And I told you guys down here to maybe accumulate some mining stocks as a swing trade or to hold long term, just in case this breaks out as I expect it and it rallies because it's breaking out from a bull flag. But I'm still hesitant right now. I bought some down here, but I didn't go all in or anything. I just bought some. I still have more, a ton of cash on the sidelines because I think the price is going to dump one more time. Why is that? Well, if the market corrects, it's going to cause margin calls, just like it did in March, and it could fall. And it could fall down quickly and fast. It all depends on the velocity of the equity market correcting. And then the Fed's going to step in, and then it's going to rebound very quickly, and then boom, it's going to go straight up. And this is the best case scenario if you want to accumulate and you don't want to miss out. And this would be your last chance to hop on that train before it leaves the station for the largest wealth transfer in human history. That's really what I believe, not financial advice. Oh, and consult your financial licensed financial advisor. I'm not a licensed financial advisor before doing anything. Stocks, everything, extremely risky, extremely volatile. Do not invest in anything you're not willing to lose or lose sleep over. All right. So, there you go. This is what I'm betting on. So, I haven't bought anything leveraged in the mining sector. Nothing like that. I'm waiting to see what happens this week. Okay. Let's talk about Bitcoin real quick. It's had a good run. My last video I said, I don't know what I said. I don't remember. But there's just more and more regulations coming out against it. And I told you guys they're going to regulate this to death. It's had a good run. Okay. It's overextended. Both. I mean, all of them are. It's going to correct. It needs a correction. And if there's any correlation, there's a correlation between cryptos and the stock market. And when the stock market dumps, so do the cryptos. All right? It happens every time. Maybe because of the derivatives on the equity markets of the Bitcoin. And they tend to, I don't know, they probably need to raise cash or something happens, margin calls. And then those funds, like, what's that one fund with the stupid commercials to dump gold? I forgot what it's called. Doesn't matter. I wouldn't buy it. It's horrible. Anyways, I there's going to be a correction, I believe. Let's take a look at the weekly on Bitcoin. Yeah, there's a 9 sell on the ETH. And on Bitcoin, there is, on the weekly, this is hilarious. Oh, wow, it hit 20,000? It made a new all-time high, just like gold. Well, what happened when gold hit its previous all-time high? It pulled back significantly, had a correction. And we have a 9 sell. This thing's going to dump. It's pretty obvious. Which is actually better for the long run, right? Why would that be? Because it would look just like the gold chart. And what would happen is you could make a giant, multi-year, giant, enormous. I'm talking like a multi-year, almost a decade size. Give me a second. So you guys can see it. There we go. Look at that. That's the cup. And then we get a correction. As you can see, this would be the correction, right? Rebounds, hits its previous all-time highs again, and then boom, shoots to the moon. You would have a multi-year, decade-long, although this would probably take another 2 years to fill out. Maybe one more year to fill out, and then, but there's going to be a correction, many months of correction, possibly, I believe. Or maybe not, I don't know, but there's definitely a correction coming. That's what I do know. All right, so I warned you guys, all right? Can't say I didn't warn you. That's what I think. Could be wrong, I could be wrong. Okay, where's Tesla? Tesla looks ready to go too. There's, listen, I think that's good enough for now. All right, guys, smash them like, share my videos, and join the private group. Take advantage of my, it's a 40% off. And this is going to be the best buying opportunity. I'm going to upload some more spreadsheets, and there's a lot of opportunities. And listen, this past spring and summer, I saw 5x, I saw 10x, I saw those types of returns. We're going to do it again this coming spring. Or maybe even a few months from now. I'm just saying, you do not want to miss the train on mining stocks for gold and silver. Especially as this world gets more turbulent, they're only going to go up. So you want to accumulate as much shares. A lot of these mining stocks have retraced 60-70%. So, and they still are undervalued to the current price of the metals. Like the mining stocks right now are valued at, like, I don't know, 1200 an ounce gold. So, and the silver mining stocks are even worse. Once the bubble pops in equities, you're going to see a huge bubble mining stocks. Huge, because it's a small market. It's very illiquid compared to everything else. There's just so much funny money floating around. It's all going to flow there eventually, especially once the currencies start losing a lot of their value. And you're not going to believe how well it's going to... By the way, this year, 2020, the best performing assets were mining stocks. But no one's going to talk about that in mainstream media. I outperformed everyone. But I don't brag, I guess, enough. I should brag more. And I got out at the top with my leveraged ETFs and a lot of the mining stocks. Some people held. I don't know why people hold. It's like, I don't know. So yeah, join that private group. Also, if you're interested on, I'm not making any promises. I also need enough people to do this, and then a lot of people need to be serious, and you need money. Not a lot, you know, I'm thinking probably 30, 40, 50,000. I mean, you could always crowdfund with your own family, pull it together. It's not that much. Take out a loan, I don't know, sell something. But, you know, the properties I'm looking at and this and that, 50 people did it. You could easily get acres and acres, like maybe 3, 4, 5 acres for like 30 grand. 100 people, yeah, I mean, you could get like 5, 4, maybe 6 acres, or I don't know. We'll have to talk about it. So, and then you could pull your RV up there. You could go camping. With time, everyone could build their own little log cabins or even a home, you know, whatever you want. It'll be your plot. That's what I'm thinking. And then, you know, LLC the property, huge tax breaks and all kinds of things. And you have freedom, real freedom. You're not going to have to worry about, I don't know, digital passports, all kinds of stuff. You know what I'm saying? Like a community, self-reliant, self-sufficient. Probably won't be easy. Would probably be very hard in the beginning, but it's better than nothing That's for sure. What else do I want to talk about? I don't know. Oh yeah, my video. Watch it. It starts off slow. Give it time and pay attention. Because I do talk about a couple things that nobody talks about. Or has talked about. And then for the private group, I'll upload another video telling you guys the possibilities of what's going to happen in the next couple of years. Alright, till next time.